Hello, we are going to show the installation of magnetic extinctiometer on the inclinometer ABS casing. We have the bottom cap, the top cap, handrail machine, datum magnet, spider magnet, release wire link and the release wire pin. First of all, we would be installing the bottom cap on the ABS casing. By drilling 4 holes and inserting pop rivet at 4 locations. After fixing the bottom cap, it needs to be sealed around by a mastic tape. We have cut the mastic tape as of the size of bottom cap. And we will wrap it around and tap it with the hammer so that there would not be any space left. And now to doubly seal it with the BOPP tape. Now the datum magnet is to be installed at 1/2 meter above the bottom cap. The side where the magnetic coil is visible will be pointed downwards and the plane portion will be in the upwards direction. Fix the datum magnets with 3 self-tapping screws. Now the spider magnet will be installed. The visible magnetic coil side will be pointed downwards. Slide the spider magnet to the desired level. Position the spider magnets on access tubing with the help of a sealing tape so that it does not slide from its desired location. Apply the tape on 3 sides of the magnet. When the inclinometer casing is lowered in the borehole, the sealing tape will be released on its own as it's a temporary arrangement and the spider magnets will be free for settlement measurement. The leaf springs legs can be made close by a release wire link around them after compressing for easier assembly. The holes of the male end and the female end of the latch are matched or coincided so that the single loop release pin is inserted inside that hole to hold the leaf spring legs, and make sure the release pin is inserted in one of the 2 holes provided in the spider magnet. Ensure that at least one of the holes of the magnet housing is aligned with the hole of other magnets fixed on different casing. After completion of installation of spider magnets and its leaf spring legs, don't forget to tie the pulling cord on the release wire pin. The pulling cords are marked individually, taking the bottommost magnet, that is the magnet which is just above the datum magnet, as number 1. The cords are pulled one by one starting from bottommost magnet. Next, a coupling will be used to join another ABS casing. It will be fixed by drilling 4 holes to fix the rivets at right angle, then seal it with the mastic tape and then with the BOPP tape. On the other side of the coupling, fix the next pipe and follow the same procedure for fixing as shown earlier. Now slide the next spider magnet and fix its leaf spring legs in a similar manner as shown earlier. Tie the pulling cord on the release wire pin and take the individual cord to the top of the pipe. Every individual spider magnet installed will have an individual pulling cord. After completing the installation of magnetic extensiometer with inclinometer pipe, cover the top with a top cap as shown here. The cords are pulled one by one starting from bottommost magnet. Continue the method for the required number of ABS casings and spider magnets. For grouting, the grouting tube can be fixed at the bottom cap. Tape the grout tube at the top also so that it does not fall into the bore hole. The grouting can be directed as by the project authorities. If it's not, then the grout mixes are as follows. For hard and medium soils, cement would be 50 kg, bentonite would be 15 kg, water would be 125 liters. And for soft soil, cement 50 kg, bentonite 20 kg, and water 325 liters. So we would be going as per this ratio.